So the topic of our project is diabetes disease detection using machine learning algorithm. So the contents of presentation are next. We are going to cover the introduction of our topic, objectives, problem statements, architectural diagram, as well as the system requirements and statistical analysis of our project. So in introduction, next करना
देखिए
so in this we have diabetes eye disease which is chronic disease affects the various organs of a human body including eye. Infrared thermography offers the digitized thermal distribution of a thermograph. It indicates the observations of a thermal variations of a surface temperature. So by using this we are going to predict the patient is suffering from diabetes or not by scanning his or her retinal images using image processing techniques. So the objectives are to design and develop algorithm for automatically diabetes disease detection using retinal photographs and to develop method for a feature extraction using various feature selection methods and to analyze and do the analysis and investigation of a disease, a retinal disease. So we are basically going to implement the algorithm. So our problem statement is next. So the purpose research work to design and implement the system that can provide diabetes disease prediction using the retinal classification. The system carried out various feature extraction using image segmentation and used the machine learning based classification algorithm to detect the actual disease. So the architectural diagram of our system is, so basically literature survey we have added some references that we have used which are so moving on to the architectural diagram. So in that we are going to take the data set and by using the image acquisition techniques we are going to train that DV and forms the classification model. In image acquisition we are going to apply the techniques such as a pre-processing, image enhancement, filtering on a data set to form a trained DV, and then from trained DV we are going to form classification model. After that we are going to input an image and then we for that image we are going to have the pre-processing and filtering, and then we subject that image to the classification model, and then after it is subjected to the post-processing histogram equalization technique. After that, mapping with the threshold values, and then we display the type of the disease that will be the last result, which are going to predict by our this image acquisitions using the classification model. And lastly, we are going to display the accuracy of our system, which includes analysis.
So the algorithm will follow some steps. So at start we will take each instance from test model, and after that we will take each instance from train model, and we will calculate their weights, their particular each instance weight. After calculating weight, there would be a particular threshold. If that weight goes above the threshold, means the weight is kind of, we can say that suffering from diabetes diabetes or not. If the weight is suffering from diabetes, we will add it into array, and if we will return that array at last step, right? So moving to the system specification, the operating system we are going to use Windows 7 or above. The language we are using is Python, and the IDE we are using is Jupyter. Coming to hardware requirements, RAM is 4 GB or above, and processor Intel i-Core i3 and above. So the data sets that we are giving the system as an input, we are taking it from Kaggle. This is the URL mentioned. Okay. Coming to the results, see there are three parameters that SVM specifies: sensitivity, specificity, and accuracy. So after applying an image as an input, we can see these are the parameters. These are the percentage that the SVM gives as a result, and this is the graph visualization. Accuracy percentage of texture features, statistical features, texture and statistical feature in graph based. So coming to the conclusion, in this system we have proposed the system that will take image as an input, and it will tell you and it will scan the image and retinal image, and it will tell you whether the image or the person, whatever the person is suffering from diabetes or not. We have used SVM algorithm. Typically SVM is used for image classification, so that's the reason we have used support vector machine classifier. And coming next, these are the references that we have referred. So same kind of topics they had, so we had referred this. Thank you. Thanks.
So here is our demonstration. We will log in. After logging in, there will be tabs such as upload files, files report, my account, change password and logout. If you want to upload files, you can upload files. Here is the dashboard. If you want to upload files, you can also upload from here. So now here, upload diabetes dataset, right? If you add, you can add your file.csv file here. Whatever your diabetes file would be there. So whatever you want, you can give its file name, and you can upload by choosing upload diabetes file. You can choose here, and description, whatever the description you want for further purposes, you can say, you can type that. You can type file name here, and you can choose file from here, and you can write description here. Going further, you can see files report from reports tab. See here, this is already diabetes.csv file. This is already uploaded. If you want to view data, you can click on view data. See, this is the contents of the diabetes.csv file that is uploaded. See here, you can see what are the columns are, how many total entries are there, 768 entries are there. So if you want to search here, you can go and search number 50. It will show all records that include 50 in it. You can say, and these are the these are the parameters you can see in our CSV file, and this is the copy section CSV. If you want to see the data in Excel or PDF, or you want to print, these are the buttons for that purpose. And these are the parameters you can see, and the total entries they have in your CSV file. It mentions in the same way. Talking about next thing. You can see also report, whatever the report we have discussed, you can also delete it if you want, whenever you want to delete, by clicking on delete section. And prediction, if you want to predict, right, you can select predict tab, or if you want to do analysis, you can select analysis tab, right? So here we can analyze. See here, you can see type of data, whatever the type of data, unit target values and all. And diabetes percentage according to data set, means in the form of graph, with the diabetes problems, without diabetes problem, right? Now these are the top five columns. And talking about data, these are the data. 1 second, file reports, and we will do now prediction, right? After clicking on prediction, let's suppose now we want to check diabetes, right? You are a user. Okay, you have your measurements with you, whatever the pregnancies, whatever the glucose is, whatever the blood pressure you have, your skin thickness, your insulin, your BMI, your diabetes pedigree function and age. See, these are the all mandatory fields that you require to enter, right? After entering this, our system will tell that whether you're facing diabetes or not by using some algorithms, right? We are going to train the model. These are the parameters you have to get trained. We are going to train the model, our model. So we will enter here some parameters, some manually parameters. I will enter in that way that the patient is suffering from diabetes. Okay, 148, 72, skin thickness, in the way that it should tell that the diabetes would outcome in suffering, right? So I'm giving the parameters manually, so that I can show you how my system will tell you that the patient is suffering from diabetes at 33.6, because BMI is in float type, so I've given it in float values. Pedigree function 0.60 to 70 to 750, right? And once I run this check and show result, it will run in the background and will apply some algorithms like SVM and others. Wait, I will show you. And see here, you can see logistic regression random forest have applied on every algorithm, and it will tell support from diabetes disease or not. You can see result, and you can see accuracy score respectively. For every algorithm, it gives that suffered from diabetes. That means the patient is really suffering from diabetes disease by resulting in every algorithm like KNN, decision tree, and random forest. So coming to the accuracy score, you can see accuracy score is not so differentiated between all algorithms. So here you can see data values entered by user, whatever the values we have entered. This is the pie chart representation. So here you can see all algorithms bar chart accuracy result in the way of visualization, right? It looks more attractive. So I've used that graph, and this is how every algorithm differs. Okay, so now I had entered values like the patient should suffer from diabetes disease. Now I will enter kind of values that will patient is safe, means he is not suffering from diabetes. Pregnancy is 1, glucose 85, blood pressure 66, you can say, and like that, in kind of like that, you can say, you can enter, means we have to assure that the patient is not suffering from diabetes disease. How the algorithm works, I want to just show you by entering manual values. Okay, insulin 0, I'm entering ground values so that you can get to know what exactly my system does at the back end, my project. Okay, 26.6. And 1, 3, 5, 1, 31. So now when I check and show result, see what happens now. See, you can say not suffered, not suffered. Every algorithm tells that the patient is not suffering from the diabetes disease. As you can differentiate how my algorithm works, you can see how it tells whether the patient is suffering from diabetes or not. And these are the data that is entered by user, and same way. Yeah. The visualization I had shown, and once we have done with this, you can also check your account from here. Whatever your account is, you can change password from here if you want to change it. Okay,